And so even though we face the difficulties of today and tomorrow, I still have a dream. It is a dream deeply rooted in the American dream. I have a dream that one day this nation will rise up and live out its true meaning of its creed. We hold these truths to be self-evident, that all men are created equal. I have a dream that one day on the Red Hills of Georgia, the sons of former slaves and the sons of former slave owners will be able to sit down together at the table of brotherhood. I have a dream that one day, even in the state of Mississippi, a state sweltering with the heat of injustice, sweltering with the heat of oppression, will be transformed into an oasis of freedom and justice. I have a dream that my four little children will one day live in a nation where they will not be judged by the color of their skin, but by the content of their character. I have a dream today.
People always say that I gave up my seat because I was tired. That isn't true. I was not tired physically, or no more tired than I usually was at the end of working day. I was not old, although some people have an image of me as being old then. I was 42. No, the only tired I was tired of giving in. I did not want to be mistreated. I did not want to be deprived of a seat that I had paid for. I had not planned to get arrested. I had plenty to do without having to end up in jail. But when I had to face that decision, I did not hesitate to do so because I felt that we had endured for far too long. I did not get on that bus to get arrested. I got on that bus to go home. Ooh.